the ski racing program, where spotlight is often on high-level, full-time academy racing, we led the Weekend Warriors, the weekend part-time group. As part of that group, we tried to offer, we didn't publicize this, but we tried to offer a very multi-layered experience. On the surface, every kid that showed up, it was about ski racing. But for those that were paying attention and got it, it was about so much more than that. These were kids that are probably not looking to get on the US ski team, probably not going to the Olympics. But the lessons that we could learn from ski racing about priorities, about passions, about teamwork, sharing, these were the things we were really after. Clay is a central character in our group, and he got it. Group including kids from all over the spectrum of athletic ability and interest level. During his time with us, he was really instrumental in setting the whole pace athletically, creating an identity of pride, humility, and competitiveness that brought out the very best in everyone around him. There's no doubt he always kept things interesting. With Clay as a major catalyst, our program began from a perceived less committed weekend program to a cohesive team where the most competitive high school racers could challenge each other in the competition. Those who had other reasons for joining our group were accepted and celebrated for their own contributions and their diversity of interests. Clay, who was talented enough and athletic enough to ski at whatever level he chose, was not only a disruptive force of nature that kept us all on our toes, but he was the glue that made our culture work for everyone. He was a key part of our identity. We'd like to thank Jeff and Jenny, Ted and Allie, for allowing us to speak on behalf of the Weekend Warriors, the Water Valley, and the New Hampshire racing community. Anywhere Clay went, he immediately disarmed and made people comfortable with his laughter. His antics were on any given day insane, goofy, I can't believe he just got away with that, gentle, and hilarious. But they were never ever hurtful or malicious. They were just humble, simple, and universally understood. Beyond that, though, Clay was real. He was genuine. He was inherently trusting and open. He didn't have any barriers of class, race, social status. He just enjoyed making human connections. As coaches, we watch a lot of young adults fight to try to understand who they are, what their place is in the world. Clay didn't have to work at that at all. He got it. It just came naturally to him. He had supreme confidence about where he was and what he was doing. As his great friend and teammate, James, said, Clay wasn't my best friend. He was everybody's best friend.
But sometimes his youthful exuberance got the best of him. And us. He was so confident in his ability that he often found himself using all of his charm to escape.
So a quick story of classic play day. One of our team values to JP for a play day, Clay decided to get just one more run in with his brother Ted and our good friend Tyler. Earlier in the day, we watched some of us here take a nasty tumble down some really steep rocky terrain under the tram. On this last run, the guys got out of the tram and Tyler and Clay proceeded to cross over the rope in toward this cliff area. Ted, who was no doubt feeling like he was the most intelligent one of the bunch, decided to be smarter than that and ski down another trail to come find us at the base lodge. As far as Ted knew, Clay and Tyler were just cliff jumping idiots, and this wasn't going to end well. So we waited at the bottom and waited. And we're supremely confident in their use T ability, but we're also equally confident they have no clue how to tell time. So the sun's sinking lower and lower, night's coming on, and we began to worry. We went and saw a secret roll. Later on, we found the playing pilots who just wanted to get some epic selfies with their skis hanging over the edge of the cliff. They never really intended to ski it. So they got the pictures, and then after Ted had gone, they went for one last phenomenal run down some gorgeous glades called Timbuktu. Fair enough, right? It's almost a good plan. It was a good plan right up until the point where they unknowingly skied past the ski area boundary, which is a big rope out in the woods, and they went off into the Vermont wilderness in February as night was coming on. Eventually, they didn't come out on the road, and they even got enough cell phone signal to call us. So there we are at 5:30 with sun going down. Russ and I are completely unaware of this. We're preparing to launch a search and rescue mission with the ski patrol and trying to figure out exactly how we're going to explain this to Jeff and Kenny, who lost the kid. The phone rings. Todd, yeah, hey, it's us. Yeah, I guess we got a little sidetracked. Sorry about that. Hey, can you come pick us up? Sure thing, Clay. Where are you? I don't know. We're on a boat somewhere. How do you respond to that? In our case, it's a steady stream of, I can't believe it. We're so glad you're okay. We are so going to smack you. We hope you found some fresh tracks and it was that big. You're so grounded. We hope it's fantastic. You don't ever do that again. Somehow, by the time we got back to Waterville Valley, we'd gotten past the whole badness thing. The whole band was laughing about it and how completely sober the whole thing was. Clay had single-handedly turned the surname into a noun, a verb, an adjective. As in, "Oh, dude, you completely sobered that." Or, "How sober was that move?" Or, "You just told us sober." All of these produced situations that could only be imagined with Clay's being. That's just how Clay rolled. There's something about his delivery and self-deprecating style made it possible to stay mad at him for long. We were mad, yet he actually got it. He understood. The reason this was classic Clay was he was very clear to us, as frustrated and worried and mad as we might have been, that this was all about good adventures with very, very dear friends. It was carpe diem. It was truly seizing the moment in front of him and making the very best of it. It was living life out loud.
Clay often put others first. He didn't always have to prioritize his personal agenda. And he was genuinely concerned about others. In addition to his unique comedic genius, Clay was genuine, honest, and open. In quiet moments, he'd share his thoughts. Had a lot of questions about himself, people, life in general. He listened more than he let on. While he sometimes looked like he was running faster than he was thinking, he was contemplative and compassionate. Clay truly enjoyed the opportunity to work with Yes, and he talked about it often. He enjoyed sharing his passion for outdoor life. He also enjoyed learning from and with people that could broaden his horizons. Did anybody smile more than Clay? He always had a smile on his face. But it was biggest when he talked about his family. Ted and Allie, he always talked about it. How you were doing, your accomplishments. He was so proud of you. Not just skiing and athletics. He talked about your friends, your travel, how you were doing in school. He also glowed when he talked about Jeff and Jenny. He gave us a glimpse into the sober family through his lens. And one thing that was crystal clear, through his one-sided accounts of the interactions he had with mom and dad, was how much he felt loved and how proud he was to be a soaker.
Place carefree attitude permeated all those around him, had a catalytic, buoyant effect on people. His Facebook page is a beautiful testament to that. There were lots of moving comments on there. One that particularly jumped out summed it all up, from Meg Walensky in Colorado. Play inspired me to become the funniest person and version of myself. Play, you had that effect on every room, no matter where you went. You brought out the very best in each of us. There's so many of us who will always keep one seat open for you, I'm sure.
Clay was a friend to many in the ski community beyond his home mountain at Waterford Valley. His charismatic and infectious personality helped him forge long-term relationships with kids from all over. Last Sunday, an entire group of kids from the Loon Racing drove to New Hampshire for Clay Day. My daughter Peyton and my son Reed both said they just needed to be together. Clay was so important. The ski racing community has lost a favorite son. Jeff, Jenny, Ted, and Allie. While none of us can take away the loss you're feeling, please know that the ski community will lift you whenever possible, and that Clay has left an impression on us that will endure forever.
Finally, we just have to say, sitting trying to figure out a fondest memory of Clay. Everybody here is trying to figure out how to beat out any of those moments. Every minute is special. So Clay,